Well, number 39, a hexagonal pyramid resting on one of its slant edge. Resting on one of its slant edge. A hexagonal pyramid, 25 mm size, 50 mm axis length, resting on one of its slant edge. And appears to be inclined 45 degrees, the third position. In this, 25 mm hexagon is there. Height 50 mm, first position, normal you are drawing. Next, it is resting on one of its slant edge, means OA is the slant edge, that is resting on one of its corner. Next, AO on XY line, it is the second position. OO1 is inclined, is the third position. Now, we will draw this by using sketch. Now, this is the 25 mm and 50 mm height. This is given in the problem. Whenever in the problem, if it is resting on slant edge, whenever resting on one of its slant edge means resting on one of its corner, corner should be right side. Next, take 50 mm height and all the projectors should be till XY line. When you are viewing from this side, A is visible. So, I will take A point here, A dash, B, B dash, inside of the bracket, F dash is not visible. Then, O1 dash, C dash is visible, E dash is not visible. That is C dash, E dash. Then this is D dash. All the points will be joined to the O point. All points will be joined to the O point. Right. Now base also we have to join. This is the front view of a hexagonal pyramid resting on one of its slant edges is nothing but corner. And height 50 mm and all the corners should be joined to the OO1, that is axis, when you are moving from the top side. Now we will mark here this D dash point and we will take distance, from D dash to O dash and we will mark or will cut on axis line. So here we'll get O dash point. Now we'll join both. This is the resting on one of its slant edge. OD is the slant edge. Next we'll take distance D dash to the A dash. We'll draw arc from D dash point and then we'll take distance O dash to A dash, right, take distance from O dash to A dash, draw arc. So here we will get A dash point. Now we join on both the side. Right. Now we will divide others from D dash to B dash, F dash, from D dash to B dash, F dash, and other side from A dash to our same distance. Here we will get C dash, E dash, here we will get B dash, F dash. Then another point, O point, I have to take distance. From D point, you get O1 dash. And join all other points. to the center O. So this is a front view of second position, that is OD. It's a slant edge which is resting on XY line. This is the second position. Now we'll draw horizontal vertical lines parallel to this, that is projector from D, then projector from C dash E dash, then projector from O1 dash, then projector from, so we'll take parallel to this once again. And also from O point. Here we'll get O point, here O1 dash, O1 point, D, D will join here, and this is D point, and then C and E's are there, E, here E point, here C point, and then here F point, and then here B point, and here it is A point. So all the points are joined. Now when you are viewing from this side, the point which is away from the observer is OD. The line joining to OD are dashed line in the top V. And also C dash E dash is a dash line, because when it is open, B dash, F dash are open. When you are viewing from top side, OA, OB, OF are open. Because of that, we cannot see C point and E point. Because of that, three lines are dashed in this problem. Please make it concur. C to E is a dash, because when B and F are open, we cannot see E point and C point. And also D is dash. Here OA is there. Till this, it will not see. Here it can be observed. And then we'll join all other points. Complete base is visible, because of that continuous line. Then we'll join O to all the points. Already four were joined. Right, this is the top V of a hexagonal pyramid. Give the arrow marks. Now OO1 is appears to be inclined in the third position at an angle of 45 degree. We'll mark here and we'll take 45 degree line. From this point we'll take 45 degree line on XY line. I'm taking 45 degree So this is 45 degree line. Now we'll mark here O point and we'll cut it by O1 distance, because right, we'll cut it by O1 because axis appears to be inclined in the third position. Now I have taken O1 point, and then we'll take OA and OD distances. directly we will get this on 45 degree line. Here we will get OD point and OE. OA distance are taken and we will cut it on 45 degree line. These are the two lines we will get directly. This is D point, this is A point. On 45 degree line we will get directly. Next, other points. So we will take from OE. AE and AC distance are same. By keeping at A point, we will draw arc. Right, then we will take distance from O to E. Please go through the construction. O to E I am taken, or O to C you can take. Distances will be same. And we will cut this. We will get two points called as E point, and here we will get C point. Next we will take O to F, or can take O to B, O to F, O to B. Then you can take distance from D, D to B, or you can take D to F distance. Distances are same. By keeping a D point, we'll cut these two arc. Here we'll get B point and here we'll get F point. Now you got all the points. We'll join base first. C to D I'm joining. Next, D to E I will join. Next, B to A, A to F. And then E to F. Sorry, a small variation. Then we'll join B to C. Then we'll join B to A point. Then all the points will be joined to O. Same will be transferred to the 45 degree line because it is appears to be inclined. Now we will draw vertical projectors from all the points. From E I will draw. And then F. B, A point, C point, here we will get O dash point and this is D dash point on XY line. Next we will draw vertical horizontal projector parallel to XY line. I got all the points. This is A dash point. then here we'll get B dash point, C dash point, E dash point, and then F dash point. Now when you are viewing from this side, the points which are away from the observer are, once again we'll get three points, that is A, F and E point. Now we'll draw the border lines first. D to E, E to F, then F to A, sorry, F is here, we'll get F point here, E to F, F to A point, then A to B, complete base is visible when you are viewing from the bottom, C to B, and then C to D. Now we'll join border lines. O to D is a border, here O to B is border, and O to C is visible when you are viewing from bottom. Other than these three lines, here we'll get, these are dash. So this is the third position. These three lines are dashed because when you are viewing from this side, D and A, right, A disappears because of B, because of E and F, because of D, E and F are disappears, means which cannot be visible when you are viewing from this side. D and B are open, because of that these three points are not visible in the front view, because of that these three lines are dashed lines. Thank you.